Okay, so this video is about mixing order, and the whole idea of mixing order is to give the chemical that have the most problems to dissolve the first shot, and the one that is very easy to mix can come in the tank last. And the products that have the most difficulties to dissolve are granules, and that's why they should come into the tank first, like your ammonium sulfate, or in this case a dry glyphosate. Now I'm putting these granules in, they sink straight to the bottom, and it needs some minutes of agitation, allow 10 minutes for granule formulations to dissolve. And then the next group is our SC formulations. In this case I have a fungicide here, which I'm using at 500 milliliter per hectare. You can see it's not that easily mixed, and we certainly need to give it some agitation, and even with that it will take a little while to dissolve. Therefore it needs to go in the tank before an EC formulation or an aqueous formulation. Okay, the next type of products are EC formulations. So in this case I have oxyfluorophane, and I'm using it at a spike rate of 75 milliliter per hectare. It readily disperses it with a bit of a agitation, there won't be any problems. But they go into the tank before the glyphosate formulations. No problem at all. Already done. Last, the glyphosate. We're looking at a 1 liter label rate of a highly loaded glyphosate formulation here. And you can see how it very easily dissolves. And that's why they should be in the tank last. Okay, so we gave it a bit of time for our granules to dissolve, and there's no problem. Perfect solution. You just need to give it a little bit of time. Our SC formulation have dissolved as well, no problems, just needed a bit of time. And the EC formulation and the aqueous formulation, they were dissolved right in the beginning. So basically every formulation did its job. You just have to put them in the right order. And I just repeat the order: granules, SC, EC, aqueous, adjuvants.